Hello students, this is S.P. Singh, PGT English from KV Vansagar, and this is my video number 2 on Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. So we stopped in our first video, we stopped at a point we were discussing that the children prefer to remain bare feet or barefooted, and they give several reasons, but all those reasons are simply excuses. The real reason is the poverty, is the lack of money. And all those excuses are only to explain away, or we can say hide, conceal their perpetual state of poverty, their continuous state of poverty. Well, now this is another paragraph on page number 15, and now we are going to discuss a story within story. I want to tell you what this story within story about. See, we are now going to draw a comparison between other sections of society and these rag pickers, these poor street rag pickers, their condition. Examples have been taken. One from a son of a priest in a temple in Udipi. Right? See that one. Narrator Anish Dang, she's saying she came across a story from a man from Udipi. He told her that as a young boy, he would go to school past an old temple, right? And at the temple, he used to make a prayer to the goddess. And remember, at this temple, his father was a priest. And his father was a very, very poor man. He could not afford to buy a good pair of shoes for him. So every day, he made a prayer to the goddess. Please grant me a pair of shoes. Okay, 30 years later, he visited the place once again. Now there is a new priest. But see, the situation, the condition has completely changed, right? There is a new priest, and see his house. There were red and white plastic chairs. And there is a young boy. He was dressed in gray uniform. He is wearing socks. And don't forget, he is wearing shoes, right? And he has a school bag also, and there is a folding bed also, right? So what do all these things show, right? Means the financial status and living standard of these priests' families has changed, right? It is uplifted, you can say. It is better now. You can say in another way, the prayer that a boy made 30 years ago that has been granted by the goddess, and okay, finally he got a pair of shoes, right? But now compare this. Means there is a change, a positive change in the condition of people like the families of this priest and others. But what has happened to the families of these poor rag pickers? See the last lines, they are important in this paragraph. But many other like rag pickers in my neighborhood remain shoeless. So shoe has been taken as example. A prayer was made for shoes by the son of priest. That prayer was granted. But do these poor rag picking boys, do they get the shoes? No. Their condition remains the same. 30 years ago, they were poor. And they are still unfortunate to live shoeless. Means without basic facilities in life. Now let's see some important lines coming in the next paragraph, right? Now narrator is taking us to Simapuri, where these rag pickers live. Now see, please focus on this line, because this makes a question. Right, Simapuri, a place on the periphery of Delhi, yet miles away from it metaphorically. This is an important line, fine. Simapuri is part of Delhi. Periphery means it is within the boundaries of Delhi. Right? So it's a part of Delhi. But then narrator saying, miles away from Delhi. So why this contrast? So it is a metaphoric language. Means you can say, Simapuri is within the geographical boundaries of Delhi. It is a part of Delhi. Right? Fine. But how is it miles away from Delhi in terms of development? In terms of basic facilities, in terms of jobs, employment, in terms of, you can say, running water, proper houses, drainage, sewage, and all the other things. Do they have all these things? No, they don't have all these things. While people in other parts of Delhi, there are luxuries. They have all basic facilities. They have good houses, good streets, and everything. So Simhapuri, in this way, miles away from it metaphorically. I hope you got the point. Fine. Simhapuri, who lives? Squatters. Squatter means people who occupy illegally a place. They do not own that land. Okay, they are squatters from Bangladesh. And when did they come? In 1971. Sahib is one of them, right? Now we are going to discuss one more point. In 1971, this is another very important line. This makes question. See, Simhapuri was then a wilderness. It still is. Another important question made from here. So in 1971, long, long ago, Simhapuri was a wilderness. See, this wilderness is coming with two meanings, two different meanings here. See, what it means, it was a plain land, you can say, no houses, no streets, no development at all. So 1971. But the narrator saying it still is, means still today it is wilderness. Is it empty? No, there are houses. But why it is still a wilderness or wilderness? What is it? See, because there are houses, there are people living there, but still it is devoid of all basic facilities, no proper streets, no street lights, no drainages, no sewages, right? So these are the things, that's why it's called wilderness. I hope you got the point. Now we are going to discuss the living conditions of the rag pickers in Simhapuri. Quickly, let's discuss. What kind of structures means structures of mud? These are their houses. And a roof made of tarpaulin, see, or tin. Sewage? No, sewage nahi hai. Drainage? Drain line bhi nahi hai. See, running water? No running water facilities. How many? ये काफ़ी पहले की बात है, 10,000 रैग पिकर्स लिव देयर. नाउ आज की कंडीशन आप देखेंगे तो इवन मोर रैग पिकर्स आर लिविंग देयर. हाउ लॉन्ग हैव दे बीन लिविंग हियर? 30 ईयर्स. सो नाउ मोर देन 30 ईयर्स दे हैव बीन लिविंग. एंड डू दे हैव एनी परमिट टू लिव देयर? लीगल परमिट? डू दे हैव आइडेंटिटी, आइडेंटिटी कार्ड्स, परमिट्स? नो, दे डोंट हैव एनी. दे आर इलीगल माइग्रेंट्स, इलीगल रेजिडेंट्स देयर. बट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंगली, दे हैव राशन कार्ड्स. So, government has provided them ration cards because they are the vote banks. Fine. So, they have their names on the voter list. They have ration cards. And because of those ration cards, they get subsidized foods from the ration shops. Okay, when, say, this question is asked them, okay, you people don't have your ID cards, you don't have permits, identity aapke paas hai nahi. To answer kya aata hai? उन्हें कहा है, देखिए, इफ एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी कैन फीड आवर फैमिलीज एंड गो टू बेड विदाउट एन एकिंग स्टमक, वी वुड रेदर लिव हियर देन इन द फील्ड्स दैट गिव अस नो ग्रेन. सो फूड इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर सर्वाइवल देन एन आइडेंटिटी. ये दोनों बात ध्यान देखिए, ये इंपॉर्टेंट बात थी. फूड इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर सर्वाइवल. हम आइडेंटिटी का करेंगे क्या? जब तक हमें यहाँ फूड मिल रहा है, जब तक हमारे पास जॉब, रैक पिकिंग का जॉब है, और हमारे बच्चे भूखे नहीं सोते हैं, एकिंग स्टमक, दैट इज हंग्री स्टमक, तब तक वो सोते नहीं हैं, तो वी विल कंटिन्यू लिविंग हियर इवन विदाउट लीगल परमिट्स. वी वुड नॉट लाइक टू गो बैक टू दोज ग्रीन फील्ड्स ऑफ ढाका इन बांग्लादेश बिकॉज देर इज नो जॉब, देर इज पॉवर्टी. सो दिस आंसर गिवन बाय one woman from a group of women in tattered sarees, right? So this is, and wherever they find food, they make their houses, they pitch their tent, they make their transit homes, non-permanent homes. Children are born in these transit homes, they grow up in these transit homes, these tents, and see this line, they become partners in survival. As they grow up, they also start rag picking, they also start earning money for the families. So this is how you can say they become partner in survival. And what is the survival in Simhapuri? Rag picking. Keval ek survival, ek hi means of earning hai Simhapuri mein, aur wo hai rag picking. Through the years, it has acquired the proportion of fine art. Now they have become very experts in rag picking. They have learned they have now learned the refined art of rag picking. Very interestingly, see that one. See, very important line coming. This makes question. Pehle bhi aa chuki hai. Garbage to them is gold. See that one.
So, Anna, this metaphor, garbage is compared with gold. See, again and again coming in the lesson. Why? See, answer is given. They find useful things in the garbage, they sell, they earn money for the family, and that's how they get food. See that one? Why garbage is called gold? See, last lines. It is their daily bread. Because of garbage, they get food. It is a roof over their heads. Right? Whatever the unke sar par jo chhat hai, tin ka, tarpaulin ka, wo garbage ke karan hai. Even if it is a leaking, matlab wo bahut acha chhat nahi hai, leaking roof hai, barsaat mein pani aata hai, seepage hai, leakages hai. But kuch to hai. So that's why garbage has been called gold. See? And aapne last line yaha dekhi. But for a child, it is even more. ठीक है, adults के लिए it is a means of survival. Garbage is a means of survival. But for the children, see that one, it is even more. साहिब ने यहाँ पर कहा है, sometimes I find a rupee, sometimes even a coin or a 10 rupee note. बहुत खुश होकर के ये कोला, silver coin in the heap of garbage, right? And this temptation, this greed, कि अब और पैसे शायद हमें garbage में मिलेंगे, this does not stop this hope of finding more coins, more 10 rupee notes. This does not stop from scrounging, from searching the garbage. Rag picking band nahi ho pati hai. Theek hai? So see the lines. Garbage has a meaning different. Dono ke liye, adults ke liye aur children ke liye alag alag meaning hai. Parent, un bachcho ke parents ke liye kya hai? Right? It is a means of survival. And for the children, see the last lines of this paragraph. It is wrapped in wonder. It is full of surprises. What surprises? They find 10 rupee notes. They find coins, right? For elders, it's a means of survival. For children, it is full of surprises. It's wrapped in wonder because they find money, right? See that one. Now, the story goes ahead further. In this paragraph, Sahib is found standing by the fenced gate of a neighborhood club. Which club? This is a tennis club, right? Okay, young men. These are rich young men, they dressed in white, wonderful shoes and dress,